So, you want to start for honor? You want to spam emotes and...
To crush your enemies, see them driven before you, and to hear the lamentation of their women.
What is For Honor? For Honor is a third-person action game with elements from fighting games. It was released in early 2017 by Ubisoft for PC, Xbox and the PlayStation. The game allows players to play the roles of historical forms of soldiers and warriors, including knights, samurai, Vikings and since October 2018 the Chinese Wulin. The game is set in a medieval, albeit fantasy setting that takes some liberties in regards to realism or historical accuracy. The playable characters in For Honor are called heroes. All heroes are unique and have their own weapons, skills and fighting styles. The most notable feature of the game is a tactical combat system, known as the Art of Battle. Players enter a dueling mode in which they can choose how to place and position their weapons when attacking the enemy. By observing on-screen hints and the movements of their opponent, which reflect their respective attack position, players are able to choose the correct position to block the other player's attacks. Players also have other special abilities, such as barging into enemies with their own shoulders, performing backstabbing swipes, area attacks and more. The game comes with a short single-player campaign and an extensive multiplayer mode, which is arguably the main point of the game. Since the release of For Honor in early 2017, it received several updates and DLCs. The game is currently in its 15th season. In each season, the players receive new heroes, maps, items and so on, mostly free of charge or easily acquirable through playing the game. And some seasons also include time-limited multiplayer modes. The current Steam player base consists of 5,000 concurrent players, but there are probably more because For Honor is primarily an Ubisoft launcher game. I generally need to wait around 2 minutes for a 4v4 to start. Afterwards you can keep playing with the same people, so you don't have to wait every time. There are 4 versions to choose from if you want to buy For Honor, not including editions where you just get some additional cosmetics. But which one is the best? Well, that depends on how much you want to play to unlock different heroes. The short version gets a standard edition. You can get it for around $10 if it's on sale, and you get a good selection of heroes to start playing. The starter edition is only available for the PC and costs around $15. It provides access to the full game, story mode and all PvP modes, with a different system for unlocking heroes. At first it may seem the best version, but most of the heroes are locked and you have to play quite some time to unlock them, and some heroes are much more expensive than in the other versions. Do not get this one. The standard edition is how the game was released in 2018. All standard heroes are unlocked, but only the 3 Vanguard heroes are customizable. To unlock customizations on the other standard heroes, you have to pay 800 steel, which is not really that much. As I said before, this is a version I would recommend to new players. In the Marching Fire edition, you get the standard edition and also the 4 Wulin heroes that were released with the Marching Fire expansion. Besides the new heroes, you also have access to the new arcade mode. In the Complete Edition you get, well, the complete game. You don't have to unlock any hero. It costs $99 and it goes on sale for around $33. I don't think it's really worth it, and it takes the fun out of unlocking the new heroes. Every hero falls on a specific class that broadly describes his or her playstyle: Vanguard, Assassin, Heavy or Hybrid. The Vanguard class is focused on being balanced, straightforward and adaptable heroes. Their versatile kit allows them to be good team filler while proving to be easy to learn because of their combat simplicity. If you are new to the game, it would be a good idea to start with this class. There are currently 5 Vanguard heroes: Warden and Warmonger of the Knights, Rider of the Vikings, Kensei of the Samurai and Tiandi of the Wulin. These heroes are durable and slow, but that comes with an advantage of being able to mow down enemy heroes with their disrupting movements and attacks. Heavies are very good at trading blows with other heroes either through the use of an all-block stance or their sheer physical resistance. There are currently 7 heavies: Conqueror and Black Prior for the Knights, Warlord and Jormungandr for the Vikings, Chugoku and Hitokiri for the Samurai and Jiang Jun as the Wulin's sole heavy. These characters are the fast and agile type who use speed to gain an advantage over their foe. They have potent damage and speed, however that comes at the cost of limited defensive options together with an offense that proves weak in the hands of the unskilled. Some walk alone, while others are excellent for skirmishing alongside allies. Currently there are 7 assassins, Peacekeeper and Gladiator for the Knights, Berserker and Shaman for the Vikings, Orochi and Shinobi for the Samurai, Nukja as the Wulin's sole assassin. Hybrids are the specialized heroes of the game, carrying traits from 2 of the 3 classes. As a result, hybrids bring a unique role to the game that they excel at that cannot be fulfilled by the 3 other classes. There are currently 8 hybrid heroes: Lawbringers and Centurion for the Knights, Highlander and Valkyrie for the Vikings, Nobushi and Aramusha for the Samurai, and Shaolin and Janhu for the Wulin. The single player is not really worth it. It's okay if you want to get to know the mechanics of the game, but beware, the multiplayer heroes can play much differently, because Ubisoft never updated them in single player.
Is this a joke?
Also, the story is pretty much non-existent and you can finish it in around 6 hours.
So? What did they tell you?
I don't speak Japanese.
On your first start of the multiplayer, you have to choose a faction and create an emblem. This does not limit your selection of heroes, every hero from every faction can play together. It only affects the faction war troop map mechanic. Also, once a match is started, you cannot change your chosen hero. There are 6 different modes, ranging from 2 to 8 players. Duel is a 1v1 and best of 5, you can play it ranked or unranked. Brawl is the same, but for 2v2, or 2 1v1, depending on who you are playing with. For 4v4 you have several game modes. Team Deathmatch with Skirmish and Elimination modes. Elimination is a 4v4 mode where players start in a 1v1 scattered throughout the map. If you can quickly kill your enemy, you can race to help your teammates, no respawns in a round. Skirmish is a more classical team deathmatch mode. Whoever reaches 1000 points first will enable the breaking of the opposing team, meaning they have no further respawns, kill the other team in this state to win the round. In both modes you will find power-ups that will boost your attack or defense. In Breach, a full castle siege is underway. Attackers and their forces must breach the castle and kill the commander while the defenders must stop them. This mode has 3 phases. In the first 2 phases, the attackers escort a battering ram to breach 2 gates. To speed up the process, the attackers can directly escort the battering ram and deal with the enemy pikemen, or kill the defending archers and replace them with their own. The more health the battering ram has at the end of the second phase, the more respawn tickets the attackers will have in phase 3. The defenders will have unlimited respawns. In the third and final phase, the attackers have to defeat the enemy commander, which is a stronger NPC with a bigger health bar. To help defeat the other team, you have access to several ballistas, and scattered around the map you will find power-ups. These can give you shields, more attack power, faster running speed, or just heal you. There's also the champion, another strong NPC which will grant everyone in the area a shield if defeated. Probably the most played 4v4 mode is Dominion. There are 3 different zones in each map to control and generate points for your team. Reach 1000 points and the enemy team will break, meaning that they will not respawn. Now you just have to finish them off. If you capture a zone, your team will receive 100 points, but if the enemy takes the zone from you again, you will lose these 100 points and they will gain them. Zones A and C can be captured by standing inside their borders. You or your opponent can stop the capture process or deny the zone from generating points when standing inside the border. These zones will also heal you if you stand inside the border and generate bonus points if you or one of your team is inside the zone, but more than one person does not generate more points. Zone B, or the middle lane, is captured when your minions reach the other side. Kill enemy minions to speed up the process, but beware, zone B does not heal you. Also, if you kill a minion, you generate 1 point for your team score, and killing enemy heroes will grant you 5 points. The goal in Tribute is for your team to take control of offerings dispersed on the map. Shortly after the game begins, offerings will spawn across the battlefield at marked locations. Players must pick them up and carry them to their base and secure them inside one of their three shrines. Every shrine gives a different blessing to the team once an offering has successfully been claimed. Players are able to steal offerings from the enemy's team's shrine at any moment. However, it will take a few moments for an offering to be placed into or removed from a shrine. Being attacked while interacting with a shrine stops the interaction. Hitting an opponent that is carrying an offering will make them drop it. If a team has all three offerings, a 30-second countdown will begin before the end of the match. The opposing team needs to remove at least one offering in order to halt the countdown. Attempting to pull out an offering will prevent the countdown from ending the round at zero. If time runs out, whichever team has the most offerings is the victor. If either team has equal amounts of offerings, the game will go into overtime until one team has more offerings than the other or when 3 minutes is up. The top bar is your health. If it reaches zero, you die. Nothing new there. The blue or orange symbol beside the health bar shows the current team of the player. With the newest patch, you are always the blue team and your opponents are always orange. A yellow overlay means the character is shielded and has extra health. If parts of the bar are red, it means the character suffers from bleeding and will continuously lose health over time. Most action costs stamina. If it reaches zero, you are winded and are unable to sprint or attack properly. If you do, and the enemy counters you, you will be knocked down and are open for a devastating attack. Also watch out for the enemy guard breaking you, you will fall down if he throws you. But you can still counter attacks and defend somewhat. Pressing the run button will let you sprint, but it costs stamina. All characters are able to roll and dodge attacks while running. Also, some characters have special attacks that require sprinting. There are light attacks and heavy attacks. Heavy attacks are slower, but deal more damage. There are three attack directions, left, right and top. Moving your guard into one of these directions allows you to attack and block from that direction. Most heroes have a static guard, which will stay until changed. All of the assassin and some of the hybrid classes have a reflex guard, meaning it will expire after a time, so you have to time your blocks with these heroes. Pressing light and heavy attack together starts a zone attack for clearing areas. Zone attacks are unique to each hero and are always the same move, direction of your guard does not matter. Attacking with a heavy attack from the same guard position as the attack of your enemy will parry him. It also opens up your opponent and allowing you to attack. To defend against multiple enemies, you have to be locked onto an opponent and switch your guard to the side from which the second attack is coming. So if you are fighting an opponent and another one attacks you from your right, switch your guard to that position. Pressing the dodge button and a direction lets you dodge in that direction. Some characters have special attacks that require dodging into the attack. If an opponent blocks all your attacks, you can guard break him, opening up for an attack or grabbing and throwing him into walls or off platforms. To counter a guard break, you have to quickly guard break your opponent back. Some attacks are unblockable, but you can still parry or dodge them. Your enemy will glow orange with a big orange symbol and a directional indicator. Bashes also can't be blocked or parried, they must be dodged. They look nearly the same as a normal unblockable attack, except that they will have no directional indicator. Some attacks will have an uninterruptible property, commonly referred as hyper armor. The character will flash white and can't be interrupted. If you are stunned, your screen will increase in contrast and the UI will disappear for a short moment, meaning you can't see the attack position of your enemy. Doing a heavy attack while having the high ground and being locked onto an opponent will perform a drop attack, which instantly kills your enemy. You also receive no fall damage.
I have the high ground! You underestimate my power! Don't try it!
If you miss the attack, you will receive fall damage and probably die. All heavy, some zone and bash attacks can be feinted, which just means cancelled. The goal is to goad your opponent to react in a specific way. You gain revenge by blocking, parrying, dodging or getting hit by crowd control and bash moves while being outnumbered. When your health bar flashes yellow, you can activate revenge. Upon activation, you will auto parry all attacks and every attacking enemy will be knocked down. You also gain a shield, damage boost and the uninterruptible status, but beware, revenge mode only works for a short time. And afterwards, you will use your shield again and be back to your normal health bar. After you killed an enemy with a heavy attack, you have the choice to execute him. Execution will disable the opponent's teammate's option to revive him, increase his respawn time, and gives you some health back. The longer the executions, the more health you will receive. As you can see, I can change the guard position moderately quick. If you didn't know it any better, you would think this is okay. Now we are going to lower the guard mode dead zone. You can find it under options, advanced controls, fight controls, tuning, controller. Here you can change all guard zones for your right stick. The most important is the dead zone. Lower it to at least 3. As you can see, I can change the guard that much quicker with a lower setting. Be sure to change these settings before playing with your controller. Or you could just play with a mouse. If you just press the emote button, your hero will do the emote once. So you need to cancel the animation with moving your character and hammer the emote button at the same time. Every hero has different feats that you can use in the multiplayer modes. These feats allow the player to help themselves, weaken enemies, call in a barrage of arrows or a catapult attack. They are tied to the hero level and are unlocked through playing. To use them in a match, you have to earn renown. Renown is only usable in the current match and each hero type earns renown a little differently. Vanguards will earn renown for controlling objectives, killing minions and being outnumbered by the enemy. Heavies are rewarded by playing the objective and teamplay, and assassins gain more renown by killing enemy heroes. And hybrids are a balance of all three and gain renown from all situations equally. There are several practice modes and tutorials to complete. For practice, you have the training area where you can freely test out any hero, even the ones you haven't unlocked yet. You can change the settings of your opponent to practice against specific moves or skills, or just activate the AI and play normally. To better learn the skills of your chosen hero, you are able to tag different moves, which will then be shown in the top right corner. The Hero Tactics mode takes this even further, showing you different combos to complete. You receive instant feedback if your timing is correct, or if you're too fast or too late with your inputs. The mode will also change your opponent correctly for the chosen combo. Apprentice and Warrior Trails are more like tutorials, where you will learn the basics of the game. If completed, you will also receive some steel to unlock stuff. There are several things you will receive after finishing a match. Steel is used for unlocking new stuff like heroes and specific customization. It is tied to your account. Experience levels up your hero to unlock more feats and customization. Experience is tied to a hero, leveling up one hero does not affect another hero. After 20 levels you will receive one reputation level and your level will reset back to 1. You will keep all your cosmetics in every unlock, it's like prestige in other games. Then there are gems that level up the season pass, troops which are used for the troop map mechanic, and lastly you will receive some gear items to equip for your hero. You need steel to enable the customizations on locked standard heroes, unlock new heroes, and to get more customizations like colors, execution moves and effects. You can easily get around 1000 steel per hour of playing each day. It depends on how quickly you can complete your orders. Daily orders give the most amount of steel and they are very easy to accomplish. Play 2 games, do 3 executions, that kind of stuff. If you want to unlock the year 1 heroes for example, you can either pay 10,000 steel or buy the year 1 pass for $10. The year 3 heroes and also most of the marching fire heroes are more expensive and are sold for 15,000 steel. For the marching fire heroes you can buy the DLC and there's also a year 3 hero pass, both go on sale for $10 each. If you want to try out each hero before you make an investment, you can fully test them out in the practice mode. For customizations, you can unlock complete outfits, colors, materials, armor pieces and ornaments. Also new emblems, executions, emotes and more. Everything is just cosmetic and will give you no advantage in game. Gear score only affects the 4v4 game modes. If you just play 1v1 or 2v2 for example, you can ignore it completely. But for these game modes, each hero has unique gear that they can equip to unlock perks that grant minor passive bonuses, giving you a little bit more customization. For example, you can get 50 more health when spawning, or all shield effects are increased by 20%. Every hero has space for 6 items, 3 for armor and 3 for weapons. Each gear piece has either 1 or 2 perks associated with them. Depending on its rarity and level, a gear piece will have different values for the perks. Rarity affects the maximum perk value a piece of gear can have, while the level will designate how fulfilled or unfulfilled these perks are in value. At Epic and Legendary, all gear will have 2 perks. To unlock a perk with your hero's gear, the value of the items have to reach a certain level, as seen on the right. You can also dismantle not needed items to receive salvage, which is needed to upgrade your items. The bars around the icon in the lower right show you how often you can upgrade your item. For example, with this helmet I can upgrade endurance 4 times. You can also change the look of an item and buy scavenge packs for steel to receive more items. Every hero has 7 perks designated to them from a perk pool of 21. These perk pools have 7 perks for offense, defense and assist equally, and its distribution determines the passive playstyle a hero may go for. However, a hero does not have access to all 7 perks, as common rarity gear will only choose 3 perks to start with. With each rarity tier, a perk becomes accessible from the 7. In the store you can spend real money for the current battle pass, different hero unlocks and hero bundles. You also can buy steel packs for real money to help unlock even more stuff. With steel you can buy legacy bundles, these are past season packages for each hero which unlock multiple customizations, unlock all feats, or buy the champion status which will give you more rewards in multiplayer for a limited time. You probably know already what a season pass is, but if not, I will explain it quickly. Every time you finish a multiplayer match, you will receive gems. These are used to level up the current season pass. The higher the level of your season pass, the more rewards you will unlock. The season will last around 3 months. There's a free pass where you get a reward every 2 to 4 levels, or you can buy the battle pass for $10. It allows you to get multiplayer rewards more often, unlocks exclusive items and cosmetics, and you get a minor experience boost. After each multiplayer match you can send out your troops to attack or defend specific zones to help in the faction war. Some zones give you an XP boost or some other bonuses. I don't really care about the troop map and just look for the experience boost zone and plant my banner, which automatically sends my troops there.
Enemy team is breaking!